Did that work, Henry?
7 o'clock? Welcome to the ordinary council meeting of Wyndham City Council this Tuesday, the 4th of April, 2017. In the spirit of reconciliation, before we begin this meeting, I acknowledge the peoples of the Kulin Nation as the traditional owners of the land on which Wyndham is being built. We pay our respects to their elders, past and present. Please stand for the opening prayer and... We pray for guidance in the council's decision-making to achieve the best outcome for the people of Wyndham. Thank you. Welcome, members of the gallery and the press, who have joined us this evening, so thank you for coming along. Obviously, we're a little light on numbers, it may be because they're all at home watching it on computer, I suppose. Tonight's ordinary council meeting is significant in the sense that we will, for the first time ever, be live streaming the meeting over the internet. This will allow all of those residents who find it difficult to attend meetings in person to watch us live from the comfort of their homes. Or for people who have other commitments on a Tuesday night, the recording can be downloaded via the Wyndham City website. Generally speaking, this recording should be uploaded to the Wyndham City website within 24 hours of the meeting. Now, some of you may have seen the notices in the foyer, but for those of you who didn't, I'm required to make you aware of the following. This meeting is being recorded and live streamed on the internet. The recording will be archived and made available on council's website. Whilst all care has been taken to ensure that your privacy is maintained, please be aware that your presence may be recorded. Apologies and requests for leave, Madam CEO?
Through you, Mr. Mayor, we have one apology from Councillor John Gibbons this evening.
Thank you. And I also note that I had a leave of absence from the 27th to the 30th of March, 2017, inclusive. Could I have a mover for that, please? So Councillor McAlangan? And a seconder? Councillor Khan? If there's no discussion, councillors, I shall put the motion. All those in favour? Against, it's carried. Confirmation of minutes of the previous meeting. Could we have a mover, please? Councillor Hooper? And a seconder? Councillor Villa Gonzalo? Councillors, is there any discussion on that item? If there's no discussion, I shall put the motion. All those in favour? Against, it's carried. Councillors, I'm also asking for a declaration of any councillors of a disclosure of conflict of interest and conflicting personal interest in any item on the agenda. Councillor McAlangan?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Agenda item 6.3.2, draft integrated water cycle management plan. I have an indirect interest, conflict of interest, section 78B, as a director of City West Water. Thank you.
Thank you. Any others, councillor? Councillors, I should say? No? Okay, then we need to move and second. No? Okay. We've got confirmation. Councillors, we go on to the first item for tonight's agenda, which happens to be on page 8. Doesn't have a file number. It's item 6.1.1. Response to the petition, request for safety cameras, street lighting and extra police. Councillors, do we have a mover for that motion? Councillor Khan? Seconder? Councillor Maynard? Councillors, is there any discussion? Councillor Khan?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Look, 77 people have signed this petition in thought of they seeking safe. There has been a number of incidents which is happen normally anywhere anyways. That's not a new. Now, personally, I believe they're requesting for CCTV cameras, but also lighting. Some of their concerns are genuine, and we have seen that now this area lately has been a light spot of number of robberies and number of car stolen and hooning, things like that. But I think the resident signing these petitions with seeking council can do something about it. But council's policy, we have not installed in the past any CCTVs on walking paths, and due to the lack of evidence, obviously inefficiency in crime prevention. Now, in my view, this is just my view, I have met a number of residents, one of the function, and they said when they leave the homes, they feel someone might get breaking in their home. And I was telling the resident, let's go and install CCTV cameras. And some guy said, actually, somebody, they still will do the same thing. So I believe CCTV cameras could be one of the solution, but lighting is definitely required. Those areas are actually having a bit of a poor lighting. I think we should consider and put more lighting so that way the crime can be reduced. And particularly, I think some of the spots where CCTV cameras is required, I'm not sure about that particular area where they have saying there has been a, or there's no report, there's no, Menston have been reported, there has been some kind of a unwanted incident, but I think CCTV cameras can be a good trial, and I'm strongly advocating, I think we should install CCTV cameras, maybe trial from here, or may look at other parts of the area, but it's important to install, let's trial. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Khan. Any other comments? Councillor McAlaney.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. From the petition, there appears to be a little data on the concerns raised, and it's difficult working with the petitioner. However, it's important that any issues that are raised, and they ring 000, and in the case of remaining anonymous, that they ring Crime Stoppers. Even if the crime may appear minor, it is extremely important that from a police intelligence perspective that they gather data so that they can put appropriate resources in that area. I can say, as the portfolio holder, safety is a priority for this council and rates consistently high on all communications from residents amongst traffic, public transport and jobs. We are working with the local police, the Neighbourhood Watch Victoria, and I'm working closely with various neighbourhood watches around Wyndham. We've recently established Safer Communities portfolio, of which we have 5 highly skilled members of our community that will work with council in steering the portfolio. And it's important to understand police resourcing is a state issue. However, council can play an active role and does play an active role in this area in advocating for police resources. In the next 5 years, the state government will be allocating in excess of 3,135 officers over and above the attrition rate and retirement rate. So we'll be working really hard with the local command to make sure that we have enough police resources in the area. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor McAlaney. Any other comments, councillors? If not, I'll put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. The next item is item 6.3.1, Rate Capping Strategic Engagement Plan. Do we have a mover for that, councillors? Councillor Gilligan. Do we have a seconder? Councillor Maynard. Councillors, any discussion? Councillor Gilligan.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. So in relation to this item, as we can see, this is examining from a strategic communications and engagement perspective the importance of having a real and frank conversation about rate capping. One of the most important things to consider in relation to this report is our submission around a growth category for councils. Right now, growth councils are under significant assault as a result of the Victorian government's position on a fair rate scheme. And it's very clear that the opposition on a state government level have no interest in changing a rate capping model. I think it is fair to say, on the basis of our council's position, we have accepted, as a result of not going for a rate exemption this financial year, but that does not preclude us from having a conversation with community around what rates are consistent with the services that we must provide. And it is very clear that Wyndham City Council, as one of the major growth councils, does it quite well in comparison to other growth councils. And when I say quite well, I mean delivering publicly owned services, publicly paid for and not privatised. And we have to accept the reality that if we do look at a model of constraining our funding opportunities, then we are essentially saying, let's take kindergartens off the books, let's look at private models, let's go down the route of user pays. And we live in a community that is significantly disadvantaged and cannot afford some of these services being offloaded to the private sector. And that is why we have to have a frank conversation around this issue, and that is why we will do so. The final thing I will say is that we need to have the facts on the table. And one of the greatest issues in this debate is merely the complexity of it. But when you consider the facts, for example, looking at what a 1% increase above the rate cap would mean, and perhaps that is a potential opportunity with a growth rate, we're talking about an amount of around $1.5, $1.6 million into council's operating budget, which would translate anywhere between $20 to $50 a year on your rates. A year. And that would mean that we can continue to deliver the services that we need. There is no doubt this is going to be a tough conversation, which will be mixed with political interests fighting against it. But what I will say is this is about the community, and this is why we need to have that frank conversation and bring them with us, because that is the only way you win on this debate, having the facts on the table and delivering a strong position. And I can assure you that Wyndham City Council will fight for this over the next 4 years. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Gilligan. Any other discussion, councillors? Councillor Marcus.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Well, I've been on the council for some time now, and it was, of course, in the last term that the state government brought in the rate capping. And as everybody knows, that Wyndham is one of the fastest growing councils in Victoria, Australia. And we had rate capping discovery committee meetings, but I don't think they were terribly clear to many of the people that actually attended those. And so what I'm pleased to read here in this rate capping strategic engagement plan is the amount of communication we are going to have with all the residents in this city. And I think if anybody out there, if you're reading through here, you will see that it's well documented that we will be having and council will be transparent and reporting back to the community on the feedback. We do have many, many people who are really, really struggling. And I have to say the rates in this city are quite high compared to other areas. And I certainly was against rate capping, but what I will be voting for this tonight, because I want it to go out to the community. I want the community to see it. I want them to have their say, because there will have to be cuts. And I believe that this is a good plan so that the residents, but we've got to get it out to everybody. So everybody needs to make sure we have a special effort to make sure all of our residents see this so that they can make up their idea whether they want to apply for an exemption to the rate capping. So pleased with this, we'll vote for it tonight, but not sure whether I'd ever vote for rate capping to extend our rates beyond the 2% at this stage. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Marcus. Councillors, any other comment? Councillor McElhaney.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. In February this year, Council agreed not to seek a variation in the State Government's rate cap plan of 2% for the 2017-18 year. And look, I believe this was a good move for a new Council. Work needs to be carried out in this area before we can justify any rate capping in this coming financial year or any future financial years. Also in February, we authorised the CEO to review the Central Services Commission decision as to why they rejected our application, the prior council's application for 2016-17, and to address some of the data and information gaps that led to the denial of any variation. The Essential Services Commission has clearly outlined in best practice principles in the areas of community consultation. And while we have commencing engagement in this area, look, I'd just like to applaud the previous council and the organisation for starting the journey, commencing with 4 district advisory panels, 11 portfolio committees, listening posts, Wyndham 2040 corporate workshops. We also have greater access to social media and communication now, and on our council website. We've had ward communication letters and council newsletters more regular than in past, in the previous terms. And we're doing extensive customer services surveys regularly is being undertaken. Tonight is an example of live streaming our meeting to the public for the first time, giving the public the ability to see their local representatives in action and not having to wait for the local newspaper or for minutes to come out. While I believe we still have a long way to go, I think we, compared to other local government agencies, I think we are way ahead, and we still have a lot of work to move forward with this, but I look forward to watching the rate capping strategic engagement plan develop over the coming months and see how this journey influences council's decision making, improves community capacity through education, strengthens relationships and networks, and how to inform the state government of the needs of our growing community. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor McElhaney. Councillor Maynard, you wish to speak before?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, I've just jotted down a few notes while my fellow councillors were speaking, and they've all been quite eloquent in what they've said. First and foremost, we need to remember that this council is a growth council. We grow between 10 and 12,000 people per year, 87 to 90 babies per week, every week, that are born to Wyndham mums. This council, being a growth council, if we are required, and I'm happy to support the motion, but I'm just expanding on my views. I'm happy to support this. This council squeezes the best it can out of everything that it does, and it's always trying to improve itself. There are some things that we've identified we need to do. We certainly go out and speak more and interact more with residents. This council, on average, has a capital spend of $120 million a year. Is somewhere between 3 and 4 times the capital spend of most councils in Victoria, not counting Melbourne and Geelong, of course. Some councils have a $20 million budget. This council spends $120 million in capital works. Why does it do that? Because this council views the need for service, for provision of infrastructure to this community, not because just because we feel like it. So to have to document what we're doing, fine, we'll do it. And we'll do it better than most, I believe. If our rate capping is not approved, if our variations are not approved, the effect of that progressively over 4 years can remove up to $40 million from our capital works budget. These are the sorts of issues that this council has to deal with. And if governments of the day, and both sides of the state government, if they want to cap rates, fine, cap rates. Give us the money, and I've said it before in the chamber, give us the money that this council needs to provide services, infrastructure to the community. Not build gold-plated swimming pools, provide the infrastructure that we need. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Maynard. Councillors, any other comments? Councillor Arm.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The key outcome of this report is that we are wanting to maintain regular and ongoing dialogue with the community, and how we can do more with less, and to ensure we are meeting community needs and expectations in this changing financial environment. And I think this is very important. Therefore, I commit this report and encourage the community to work with community and to work with the council around this. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Arndt. Councillors, any other comments? If there isn't any, I shall put the motion. All those in favour? Against, it's carried. Item 6.3.2, the draft integrated water cycle management plan, and Councillor McElhaney, I'll ask you to leave the chamber. Thank you. Councillors, could I have a mover for this motion, please? Or this recommendation, I should say. Councillor Khan, seconder. Councillor Hooper. Councillors, any discussion? Councillor Marcus.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Well, it's great to see this draft integrated water cycle management plan. As we all know, we all need water, so water is life, as the kids many years ago put on the real estate board when we had the draft. And I still have those real estate boards lining my fence because I was so proud of the work that the kids did in the secondary college on our water supply. As with all communities, water does play a crucial role here in Wyndham, and we have unique water-related characteristics, including the iconic Werribee River. Now, our Werribee River is, I love it, but it's sadly in need of some care, and we will be doing this, and I'm very proud to think that I have been given the opportunity to be on the Environment Committee, and that's one part we will be looking after. When we set about forming our Environment Committee, we had 37 people that applied, and so we had some wonderful people that actually applied. It was very difficult to get our committee together. And we're very proud. We have our first meeting on Wednesday night, and we have outlined what we want to look at in the next 4 years. And of course, this comes just at the right time for us to be looking into how we're going to do that. We have an expert on water who's come onto this committee, so we feel that we will make a big difference over the next 4 years. As you all know, we have our irrigation district here, and they haven't had an easy time because they haven't had all the water allocations they needed. It's very salty, and so therefore we feel we can make a big difference. But everywhere we go, the race course is in dire need of water, the golf club and everything like that, so it's very important. And I think what's been put together here is wonderful. It's been put together by the former Environment Committee, so once we take and start work on Wednesday, we will be looking into that because this plan has to go out to the public for comment. So we will get the comments back, and then we, as the new portfolio people, we will look into that. I'd just like to say to the council officers, and especially Kate Roffey, thank you very much for putting this together. As I just said before, if we don't have a good water supply, it's going to be very difficult to have our beautiful parks and gardens. And something that wasn't in here is that Werribee or Wyndham is one of the driest and hottest suburbs in Melbourne, and this is another reason why we need to make sure that we're well on top of everything. And Wyndham's rainfall is decreasing, although we've had a few storms recently. But yes, we need to work very hard, and we will be educating everybody to make sure that we understand that without our water, we have no life. So thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Marcus. Any other discussion, councillors? If not, I'll put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. Thank you. If we could ask Councillor McAloney to come back in, please. Councillors, the next item on the agenda is item 6.5.1. The extension of contract C1326/10 garbage recycled green waste collection service. Do we have a mover? Councillor McAloney. A seconder, councillors? Councillor Khan. Councillors, any discussion? Councillor Khan.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The company which we are awarding the contract is JJ Richardson. I've got this contract on 2010 with the option for 7 years to provide their services, plus 2 year options to exercise. Council is giving an opportunity for JJ Richardson's to come forward and giving them opportunity, which is putting forward now, so we can give them a 2 more year contract that will expire on 2020. And after that, council might make a decision to bring more parties and open the tender for the other parties who might interested providing these services. The great thing about it is that most of the councils actually paying for per bin, $138.63. We pay still below, which is $132.43, which is quite competitive and is quite good compared to other councils. Now, their service standard is quite, here mentions quite, looks very standard and looks very good. They're talking about that now that the 10,000 household is comparable to the other council, and the missed bin per 10,000 household for Wyndham is 4.32 compared to the other councils 4.16. So I personally believe they're doing a okay job, and if we will give them two more hits to be exercise their option. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah, thank you, Councillor Khan. Councillor McElhaney.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have no concerns with the recommendation to extend 2 years. The price is competitive. It's an efficient service, so much so that approximately 6:10 every Tuesday morning, I wake up to the rubbish service. So I can say that is very efficient and timely. Thank you.
Councillors, any other discussion on this item? If not, I'll put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. The next item, councillors, is 6.5.2, Road Management Plan Review. Do we have a mover? Councillor Hooper. Seconder? Councillor Maynard. Big enough to ring a bell. Councillors, any discussion? Councillor Hooper.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Road Management Plan is an extremely important document that outlines the service standards that the community can expect when it comes to the maintenance of repair of roads and road-related infrastructure. All councils are required to have in place a Road Management Plan which responds to our statutory duty to inspect, maintain and repair our roads. The plan ensures that we have a publicly available standards for then and we can resource accordingly. This process that we're now undertaking provides for the opportunity for the community to have feedback on Council's Road Management Plan, and we encourage residents to have their say. This is one of the most important functions that Council is responsible for, and we welcome input from the community.
Thank you, Councillor Hooper. Any other comment, Councillor? Councillor Shaw.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So I would like to briefly speak about item 4.4.12 on page 82 of the Road Management Plan, which covers nature strips. Taking pride in our city and of our nature strips is an important priority for me. Some residents may not be aware that residents are responsible for maintaining their nature strips, which may include mowing, weeding and litter control. Some residents may not also be aware that Council currently maintains 1,200,000 square metres of parks and open space. Nature strips are an important part of our urban environment and the appeal of our local residential streets. Nature strips offer a range of benefits such as absorbing rainwater and reducing stormwater runoff. They can also add to property values, but more importantly, make our streets look more appealing. Many residents already look after our nature strips and do so with great pride. Unfortunately, there are some residents that do not. I am taking a particular interest in this over the next 4 years and have had residents already contact me since being elected about the state of some nature strips. It's important residents are aware that these incidents may be followed up by council officers. I do look forward to seeing the community's feedback regarding this plan. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Shaw. Councillors, any other comment? Discussion? Councillor Marcus.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Again, this is a great road management policy plan. It does take in a lot of work for our City Council, probably apart from planning. This is a very major part of our works. And as you can see, not only nature strips, as Councillor Shaw has said, but building site, footpath maintenance, everything. The part that I'm very interested in is our street trees. And I'd like to see street trees that are not going to grow up between the power lines, and which causes a lot of problems. But it takes in bridges, major culverts, and a whole lot of other things. So I'm pleased to see this, but I just hope that when this goes out for public consultation, that people will have a really good look at it and comment. We want that community consultation from everybody. So again, well done to our officers for this great report, and I look forward to coming back and seeing what the residents have put forward for us to implement. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Marcus. Councillor Gilligan.
I'll just be brief. I just want to echo the comments of Councillor Shaw in relation to nature strips. This was a critical issue, believe it or not, during the election campaign. There were two major issues for me: roads and nature strips. Get on board and have a look at this particular plan, make a contribution given that it's out for public consultation, take pride in terms of your front lawns, and most certainly make sure that if you want to have a say in relation to roads, now's the time to do it in relation to this road management plan. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Gilligan. Councillors, any other discussion? If not, I shall put the motion. Oops. Oh, Councillor Maynard.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, this is just another indication of the importance that Council places on its community and the feedback, hence the public, out for public comment. I've just made a few dot points, and I'll just read them if I may. Road maintenance is extremely important from a community safety perspective, and the onus is on Council to have in place a robust system for the monitoring and repair of roads in our city. It is also important for our community to have an understanding of these maintenance standards when reporting to Council, and this Council has a very, very important, or places important an importance on the reporting of these matters through our customer service reporting system. Key changes that Council is proposing as part of this review is for more frequent compliance inspections for main roads and street trees around power lines, improved intervention for cracked footpaths, and improved response time for a range of road maintenance and cleaning actions. And there's been some mention tonight by councillors about footpaths. I will certainly be watching with keen interest on the feedback that we've received from community. I have some comments that I will make about what I think may be included, but I certainly welcome and wait for the response from our community. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Maynard. Councillors, any further discussion? If not, I shall put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. Thank you. Councillors, the next item is 6.5.3, Assembly of Councillors. Do we have a mover? Councillor Arm. A seconder? Councillor Shaw. Councillors, any discussion on this item? If there's no discussion, I'll put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. Madam CEO, are there any notices of motion?
No, Mr. Mayor, there are none.
Thank you. I believe there's no items under item 8. 8.1, under the council seal, I should say there is one, and that's a contract award of C1838/17 Hoppers Lane upgrade. Councillors, is there a mover for this motion? Councillor Gilligan. Is there a seconder? Councillor Maynard. Councillors, any discussion on this upgrade? Councillor Gilligan.
I'll make one very brief comment on this, Mr. Mayor, and I'll simply say I look forward now that we are laying the road in relation to this project, that the state government also lays the road to the development of the Werribee East Employment Precinct. I know we look very much forward to seeing what comes out of that, and we hope that that isn't too much longer in relation to that project. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Gilligan. Councillors, any other discussion? Councillor Hooper.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. As the summary of this report states, the recent completion of Snides Road Freeway interchange and the Princes Highway and Hoppers Lane intersection upgrades has increased traffic and generated the need for upgrading the missing link along Hoppers Lane between Snides Road and Princes Highway. Within these works, the road, footpaths, landscaping will be built to improve traffic, pedestrian safety and the look of the area. It also aims to reduce the congestion and travel times overall, which are ongoing concerns for our community. There was a report going back in 2012 in The Age that stated new suburbs in Melbourne are so poorly designed that residents face an endemic of chronic diseases such as obesity and depression that will result in the health system costing millions, as the state government inquiry was told. Councillors in outer growth areas say soaring populations have outstripped their ability to provide basic infrastructure such as public transport, parks and medical services, and are creating obesogenic environments that are promoting weight gain. With this ongoing issue, it is important for planning and roads and services to address the issues of now and in the future, which is why I commend the previous council and the officers for this project and the due care and consideration that's been given into its development. By awarding this contract, we're making the steps in the right direction of addressing the concerns of our community so that people can move about more freely in this city, deal with less headache on the road, and instead spend quality time on themselves and their loved ones. So thank you all.
Thank you, Councillor Hooper. Councillors, any other discussion? Councillor Maynard.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I too welcome the upgrade of Hoppers Lane. I certainly, and there has been a bit of a theme tonight on footpaths, I certainly welcome the addition of a footpath on the eastern side of Hoppers Lane. So we'll be able to cycle both ends and walk both sides of Hoppers Lane, I should say. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Oh, one thing I will say also is I hope that the frequency of the light changes does reflect a right-hand turn into Hoppers Lane that's conducive to ease of movement.
Good point. Councillors, any other discussion? Councillor Khan.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Look, I won't go into detail because it's to do with contract awarding and the pricing to the contract. So, glad to see that this comparison has been given and we are awarding the contract to the Negri Contractors Pty Limited. So it's clearly said that how they have been priced and we've selected this contractor to award this. And as other councillors have said, that it's good to see that, you know, the mislink between the Snides Road and Hoppers Lane and obviously attached link to the Princes Highway, that will be good to see the drive of the good cars because it's actually have the not a good road. So I think it's good to see that, you know, it's getting some money and they will do the good job. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Great. Thank you, Councillor Carr. Councillors, any further discussion? If not, I shall put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. The next item 10, questions with notice from the gallery. Madam CEO.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We do have two questions this evening. The first comes from Mr. Ron Fenton, who is in the gallery with us this evening. Hi, Ron. And the question relates to the Anzac Commemorative March, which will be held on Sunday, the 23rd of April in Watton Street, Werribee. Council rightly expects to march in the dignitary party. Medals and uniforms are worn. If the Mayor marches, can he honour veterans by wearing official robes? So through you, Mr. Mayor, to Mr. Fenton, it's something that we're certainly happy to entertain with the RSL. From a protocol perspective, we just need to check with them that they're comfortable about the Mayor wearing the robes, and if they are, then certainly the Mayor has indicated to me that he is happy to wear the robes. Thank you. Thank you very much. So we'll follow that up in due course, and the Mayor will no doubt don the robes for that occasion. Thank you.
It's going to be a long walk carrying that heavy chain, I'll tell you. Okay.
Mr. Mayor, we have another question from Lisa Heinrichs, who's in the gallery this evening. So thanks for your question, Lisa. This relates to the flag. And you'll recall, Mr. Mayor, we've had a number of questions associated with the flag protocol here at Council previously. So this question relates to disappointment around seeing the Australian flag still up in the dark this evening. Can Council explain why it has so much trouble getting protocol for this right? Do you intend to place lighting, and if so, when? So through you, Mr. Mayor, I will ask our Director, City Life, Ms. Jenny McMahon, to respond to that. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam CEO. And through you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, Lisa, for that question. There has been a couple of occasions, as you're well aware, last year where we did have issues with the flag raising. I'm disappointed, as you are, to see that the flag's still up there and it's not illuminated as is required. I have already emailed the relevant manager as soon as it was brought to my attention to see what we can do to make sure it does happen. I guess we were trying to save some costs from not illuminating the flag at night as is required by having a staff member raise the flag in the morning and remove the flag before dark. If that can't happen, then I think the only other alternative is for us to consider some illumination, but I'll certainly try and get to the bottom of the protocol and find out why it's not being implemented.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. That was the final question for this evening.
Right. Thank you, Madam CEO. Madam CEO, is there any urgent business?
No, Mr. Mayor.
Councillors, the next item is confidential business. I'd like to call for a councillor to move for a motion, please. Councillor Maynard.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, the motion is that pursuant to section 89.2 of the Local Government Act 1989, standing orders be suspended and this meeting of council be closed to members of the public in order for council to discuss confidential business.
Thank you. Could we have a seconder? Councillor Hooper. Question about that, I'll put the motion order.
Mr. Mayor, I move that the recommendation of the closed meeting of a council with regard to confidential matters be adopted.
Moved, seconded, Councillor Khan. Moved by Councillor Maynard. Any discussion, councillors? If not, I shall put the motion. All those in favour? Against? It's carried. And councillors, I declare this meeting closed at 7:42.
Four.
That's not wrong. 7:44. And I'm sure one day...